Hachette Children's Group presents The World of Rachel Bright and Jim Field. Hachette Children's Group presents The Lion Inside, written by Rachel Bright and illustrated by Jim Field, read for you by Bill Nye. In a dry, dusty place where the sand sparkled gold, stood a mighty flat rock, all craggy and old. And under that rock, in a tiny full house, lived the littlest, quietest, meekest brown mouse. He was so very tiny, so incredibly small, that nobody noticed him ever at all.
Hello.
He got trod on and sat on and missed out for stuff, ignored and forgotten.
Ouch!
Yes, mouse life was tough. Meanwhile, far above, on top of the rock, times were quite different. It was lion o'clock. This huge, toothsome creature made sure everyone saw how important he was by how loud he could roar. He was head of the pack. He was shouty and tough. He loved showing the crowd he was made of strong stuff. Yes, all were impressed by this mighty king cat.
If only, thought Mouse, I could be more like that.
Then late one dark night in his Minnie Mouse bed, the cleverest thought popped into his head. He jumped from the covers and held up a paw.
I've got it, he said. What I need is a roar.
I mean, what if this mouse, with the weeniest squeak, was a little more and a little less meek?
Well, he'd still be the smallest of fuzzy brown mice, but he'd make friends and join in, and life would be nice.
Yes, thought the mouse.
I must find out how. I will learn how to roar, and I will learn it now.
But gulp, oh my gosh, there was only one beast who could teach him this thing, but might make him a feast. It was time to be strong, take a chance. After all, forever was such a long time to feel small. So he made himself brave, and he thought like a winner. He set off for the top, hoping not to be dinner. It felt like the scariest thing he could do. But if you want things to change, you first have to change you. The further he climbed, the closer he got to the slumbering lion reclining on top. Then at last, as he stood on his tippity toes, he found himself suddenly nose to nose.
Pardon me. Wake up, Mr. Lion. You've got company. Mr. Lion, what I've come to you for is, Squeak, do you think you could teach me your roar?
A silence befell that twinkling plain. Lion opened his eyes and puffed out his mane. Time slowed right down. Why? It felt like a week. Then he opened his mouth and let out an
eek!
The lion was shaking, his paws all a fumble. He was backing away with a scrambling tumble.
Don't hurt me, he whimpered. Oh, try to be nice.
Well, my goodness, this lion was frightened of mice.
Don't worry, Mouse peeped. I'm a friend, not a foe. Let's rock this together. We'll have fun, don't you know?
That was a magical moment for sure, when Mouse didn't feel at all small anymore.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.